Hi guys, today we are going to see IoT based online access control system for vehicles and truck loading wheels terminals. So this is our abstract. So nowadays the world is moving towards the use of the future internet concepts. So this project presents a developed IoT based access control system for vehicles passing through the entry and exit gates in truck loading wheels terminals. Developer system follows a new design approach utilizing an RFID like frequency, radio frequency identification here mainly used. Okay, so here the system performance with regard to speed, security and allocated resources. This is our objective. Our objective is internet of concepts here used to applying one of the key IoT enabling technologies, which is the RFID like radio frequency identification. So here automatic identification and data capture technologies used. So this is our introduction slide. Existing system monitoring systems are necessary to track the changes in the environment. So here camera based monitoring device is built to access and enter into fuel point. Disadvantages: humans need to regularly monitor the fuel point entry and then exit. So there are increasing number of entry points, means we need to increasing the gatekeepers to monitor, or increasing number of gatekeepers for the loaded trucks. Proposed system here we are using RFID offers these advantages because it relies on a radio frequency to transmit information between the tag, also known as the transponder. So here tag cloning security attacks like those read-only calls from the access read-only without any capabilities of writing application specific data through the access control systems. So here cloning security will be attacked to our access control systems only. So here technology is being used in wide range of applications including public transportation, library book management, supply chain tracking and access control. So online access control system having RFID readers which are networked to a central computer, in contrast to offline systems which are not networked. So offline systems are not networked, our RFID readers are networked to a central computer. Advantages here: overall system efficiency is a speed, security and then allocated resources as available. Hardware requirements: we need an Arduino, RFID reader, RFID tags, step down transformer, buzzer, LEDs and then bridge rectifier. So software requirements: we need an Arduino IDE to program embedded C programming here, and also we send the data to IoT page. IoT page acts as a cloud storage here. This is our block diagram. RFID tags met with RFID reader means the unique ID will be captured and then validated and then sent into Arduino. You know, like if it is a true means RFID reader, and then IoT page will be enabled to access the data. So this is our workflow. Swipe RFID card. RFID card valid means so it will be allowed to next process, or otherwise invalid means red LED will be glow here. So read RFID card, and then gather reader validation, card validation, order validation. Those data are valid to match with our database system, and then signal gate controller to open. Then signal will be sent into gate, then it will be automatically open, then vehicle entry or exit. So this is our workflow: database, web server, RFID reader. Whenever vehicle come close to RFID reader, it will match and then data will be gathering from the database. So this is our working model. RFID card writer along with its embedded components, host workstation transmits the encoded order specific data to the RFID card writer, which in turn writes it to this RFID proximity card. So vehicle is to be allowed entry or exit by the developed access control system only if the unique data stored in the RFID card. In addition to the RFID card, unique identifier match those stored data in the database, thus adding a new layer of security to the system. So we can able to gather data from database and it also will match to our RFID card received data. So this one is our explanation about how it works. order validation. The order number exists in the system database, order status, permits, entry or exit. So additionally, for a vehicle to exit this site, the system checks that there are no remaining quantities for this vehicle. This one is our Arduino Uno microcontroller. Here mainly we are using this microcontroller, name as Atmega328P. ASP8266 is a Wi-Fi model to enable, like, to communicate with our web server, such as IoT, cloud storage. So MFRC522, RFID reader, here we are used RFID tags. Buzzer will make a sound, like we need to set. If it is a correct means, it will allow, otherwise it will not correct our RFID reader cards means. It will make a sound. So depending upon our programming logics, we can apply when we need to make a buzzer sound. This is LED transformer here using step down transformer, 230 volt into 12 volt AC. Bridge rectifier unit, it will convert AC into DC. IC7805 voltage regulator, so 5 volt regulator, it will give the 5 volt output. So this one is a 12 volt voltage regulator, it will give the 12 volt from this IC. Arduino IDE, this is our Arduino IDE image. IoT page, here only we can able to see the those store datas and then storing datas. Applications, hospitals and homes, medical sectors, chemical industrial applications. So feature scope, your camera connected to the microcontroller might help the user in taking decision and to recognize the number plates and driver's data. So here vehicle number plates will be gathered and then matched with the database if it is a correct vehicle or not like unregistered vehicle. So if the driver identifies the fuel level, then automatically call the particular fuel point area located nearby their location. So conclusion, this is our conclusion. References, this is our reference. References of like proposed or existing system. So this one is a existing system references. That's all. Thank you.